Welcome to part 6, the final episode of my 3D screencasting series. In today's episode, we're going to learn how to create ultra cool 3D shadows, and we're going to make some subtle refinements to our animation that really helps sell the motion. Let's get started. Okay, but there's a couple of things that are missing here. Well, actually one big thing, and that's the shadow on this control panel. I'd like to see a shadow on this because we've got a 3D light shining in it. Now, in order to have a shadow show up, we're going to actually twizzle back to transform properties and come down to this window compositions material options. These material options show up when you toggle on the 3D layer capability. So we'll open those up and we're going to come over to cast shadows and we're going to make sure that's turned on. And you can see the shadow starts to show up behind here, but I'm not real happy with this. So I'm going to go ahead and play around with the spotlight's position and properties and try and get it so that I've got a shadow set up the way I want. In order to do this, I'm going to switch my view to two views horizontal. We're going to make this one fit. And now I'm just going to grab my spotlight and I'm going to start playing around a little bit. So let's bring in a little bit. Maybe change that point of view. And you can see just by moving the spotlight around, I'm starting to get the characteristics that I wanted to see here. If we come over to one view here, and we take a look, you notice now I've got this shadow that's extending off to the right and below. You can see it behind it there. You can even see areas that are less transparent versus more opaque in the shadow. So that's a pretty cool effect. And when I zoom in on that timeline, and you can see now I've got this really, really, really cool looking animation. Now, a couple more things I want to do to sell the fact that we've got motion here is I want to turn on motion blur here for this layer. So I'll turn on the motion blur toggle and I'll make sure it's enabled. So I'm going to click it there. And what that does is now when there's actually motion of this panel, you can see I get this blur effect. And that actually helps sell the fact that you've got movement going on. The final thing I'll do is actually just add a little bit of an ease in. So I'll select these first keyframes. I'll go ahead and choose keyframe assistant, easy ease in. Okay, and we'll go ahead and move back a little bit and do a RAM preview and see what we've got here. And you can see from a RAM preview, we've got this really cool little movement out. Very beautiful, very cool looking effect here.
Hey, thanks for watching, you guys. You made it through the super long tutorial, and I really appreciate you taking the time to spend with me. Well, if you can't tell, I'm super excited about this whole space, right? We get to create this really gorgeous looking footage and make it look different than people have ever seen before, right? It's just beautiful to look at, it's fun to play with, and I'm super excited about the whole venue arena that we're in right now. But it's early days. These are just really early ideas, just showing you how the terrain looks like. And I'm really counting on the rest of you to go out there and take these ideas, refine them, expand them, and blow them up. Let's change people's attitudes about screencasting. Let's change people's attitudes about learning. It can be fun. It can be fun to watch a screencast, and we just have to put a little bit more effort into it and refine our techniques. Whew. Now that I'm off that soapbox, thanks again. I'll see you guys next time. Until then, happy screencasting.